Hi everyone. Today I'm going to give you some tips for stamping on fabric. I've had a lot of people ask me about this. Sukuniko makes an ink called VersaCraft, and they also make some markers called Fabrico, which are washable in the washing machine and they will not wash out. They're permanent. And it's really, really simple to do this. The first thing I'm going to do on my little baby gift here is make a frame. And for that, I'm going to use the negative space from a Nest Abilities that I had sitting over on my table that I figured I could get another use out of. And then I'm going to take a little finger dabber sponge thing, put that on. I'm going to use VersaCraft chocolate, and I'm just going to make it very light because I don't want it to necessarily overpower my stamped image, but I do want some sort of a frame. So I'm just going to go around a little bit on the edges. There's no super special technique to this. I do have a piece of cardstock underneath the first layer of my shirt just in case it goes through, which it usually doesn't, but better be safe than sorry. This baby gift is for my friend Ashley, and it's late because, as many of you probably already know, she had her baby 2 weeks ago. She's from Hearts Hugs Designs and does the Etsy Inspire challenges. And I really thought I'd have this done before the baby, but better late than never, right? Although I am now trying to hurry so that he doesn't outgrow this onesie before I get it done. Okay, there's just a little frame for my image. I'm using a little giraffe. This is from a Close to My Heart zoo set that I just got. And I'm going to do him in brown as well. No, actually, I think I'm going to do him in yellow. And I will color his spots brown. So we'll have a little switch. Okay. I'm going to ink them up. The VersaCraft ink comes in the full size pads as well as these little small ones. However, if you're like me, you have really more ink pads than it seems necessary, and yet they all are. So I prefer to buy the little ones when I can. They ink up just as easily, just as well. There's no real difference. They're just cheaper and easier to store. So just simply place them on the fabric, lift them up, and I will position it. There we go. There's my little giraffe. I'm going to take my brown marker. These markers have two tips. One is a fine tip. The other side is more of a brush tip. I'm going to use that. And I think that I will color his spots in just a little. Now these markers on fabric, you can't really blend as much as you would do with Copics on paper. It's not really the same effect, but they are fun to use. They give you some more options. Do his little eyes, his little antler things, and maybe a little in his ears. And his little smile, his nose, what else? His tail. Do a little more on his spots. One of the things you want to always remember when you're stamping on fabric or painting on fabric or using textile mediums, any of that stuff, you always want to be sure to wash the fabric first. Do not use any fabric softener. Do not use a dryer sheet. And that way you have better, your ink or your paint will set better. Okay, I'm also going to take a little Studio G stamp set and put a little saying on here. This one says, cute as a button. Studio G stamps work really well with this ink on fabric. I've made quite a few baby sets if you've seen them on my blog. So right underneath here, put cute as a button. Stamps perfectly. This set also comes with a little button. So we're going to put a little button, I think in green, this is spring green, on each corner. I would use a real button, but I have this paranoia about babies being uncomfortable, but they can't tell you. And I wouldn't want to sleep on a button on my stomach or lean on somebody, so I'm stamping buttons. There you have it. All done. And this will be a portion of Ashley's little gift basket. These inks are not available on my website. However, I do special orders every so often. I will be doing a special order coming up soon. If you want to place an order, all you need to do is let me know. Send me a list. Go to the Sukaniko website. I'll have this information up on my blog as well. And I usually give people, I don't know, a week, 2 weeks, whatever it takes, really, I'll work with you. And I do the orders every so often. So we can get the markers, the small ink pads, the large ink pads, really anything else on the site. But if you're interested, these work really, really well. Last thing you're going to want to do before you put it away, take a heat gun, just heat it up a little. This will set the ink. And you have a permanent little design. Quick and easy, nothing to it. You can make matching socks, bibs, hats. I like to do napkins. I'll be doing some of those for the holidays. Some towels. I'll have a video coming up where I do a stamped Halloween towel and color it in. A little more coloring than this one has. There you have it. I hope you guys found that useful, and I hope you enjoy, and let me know if you try it and how it works out for you. Thanks.